all my money.
Reveal your cards.
Three aces, two kings.
Royal cards.
All my money. All my money. Go.
Wait a second.
Brian,
I thought I was fiddling about with the sleeves.
Thank you for coming. It's been so long.
Thank you for inviting me.
This is the famous lawyer Eric Jones. Wait, no, he's not a lawyer.
Yes, I am.
I'm sorry, my husband has Alzheimer's disease. It makes him forget stuff.
Next to him, his wife Allison. And my wife has already introduced herself.
I have
Elizabeth. Oh, my son's here.
Have you got it?
Yes.
Good. It'll be sometime midnight, right?
Now we can eat. Butler!
Okay.
Oh! You stupid man! If you would drop my favorite food!
My father has died recently. You will remember him, John.
I was an orphan once. My father had dark brown hair, olive skin, and brown eyes.
Beans?
Oh, sorry. I'm very jumpy today.
I'm sorry, dear.
I'm sorry to hear that. I can imagine what you're going through. I'll be playing poker. Who wants to join me?
Deal me in, okay, champ? Let's go.
I remember starting poker in my 30s. I was quite good at it.
I think I'll entertain the rest of the guests.
What do you do for a living?
Well, I'm kind of a scientist. I make poisons. You know, rat poison and stuff. I have some with me if you're interested. You're a doctor. I heard.
Where do you keep your samples?
I keep them locked in a cupboard.
Huh.
I need to leave now.
Poor girl. She lost her mum really early, and her father didn't want her. We decided to look after her. Too high above it all. Have you ever been married or loved a woman? Throw it all away, I love father. Don't throw it
all away, I love. Can't say I have, too busy.
What was that?
What do you think you're doing up there?
It's a case. Someone stole something from us.
Mr. North, your wife has just been robbed. I just want to know what time Eric left.
Mr. Jones left at 17.
Hey guys, I realized I could just be
Thank you.
Well, Mr. Wright, I think we're going to retire to bed. Let me show you where you'll be sleeping.
Wow. You have a lot of guest rooms. Thank you for letting me stay here.
I'm sorry to disturb you all, but I think I saw someone looking around out there. It's all right, everyone. You can just go back to bed. There's a way. Everybody said to do each and every little thing. But what does it bring if I ain't got you?
I'm very sorry, Mrs. North, but he would have seen it in the morning.
We need to call a detective out there.
Doctor! I'm a detective. Yeah.
We better get a call of our detective!
We already have a detective, so let's use him.
Yes, quite right. Butler?
Yes?
Do you and you only have the keys to your kitchen?
The masters and mistress have the keys.
Okay, thank you. Somebody call for a doctor. Have you looked at the body yet? Autopsy, of course. Go ahead then. Yes, we can see that. Rat poison. Rat poison, though, doesn't actually kill humans very well. Thank you very much, this has certainly helped indeed. This also means the murderer is not alone.
Preposterous. You mean to say that there are multiple murderers in the household?
Precisely. Right. Can someone please go fetch Eric and Allison and send the doctor out?
I'm off to fetch some clues.
Been locked again. A fall from this height could be potentially dangerous, but not dangerous enough.
I'm gonna start the interviews. I might start with Nathan.
Very well.
7:05 when Owen North arrived. No questions, just tell me what that was all about.
I suppose I better tell you the truth. Last week, Owen was sent threat letters about his father. We are able to decipher them, which told the date of his death.
Who sent the letters? Do you remember?
I think it was Mr. Desire, but I can't remember the first name.
Mr. Desire, I see. When were you at 8?
I was in the server room on the second floor.
Very good. Where were you while tea was being cooked?
I was sending to Mr. North, Eric, and Mrs. North. Can't confirm this.
Okay, wait, hold on. Why was Eric here?
He was doing some business work with John.
If you locked the door to the kitchen, why did it suddenly come open again?
Every night, my master goes downstairs and has a midnight snack.
So, he must have left the door open, giving the murderer their chance. Oh, and Nathan, how long have you been working with Mr. North?
Oh, ever since he had a son. Wait, no, sorry. Ever since he was rich, which was probably 20 years ago.
I'm willing to bet that you're not supposed to have this key. It looks like a master key. Could you please get Mrs. North to come to the interview room? Good morning, Mrs. North. How are you? I'm sorry for your loss.
Just come on, get on with the interview.
Yes, quite right. Did you by any chance leave your keys in your room?
Well, I didn't think I had to take them with me, did I?
No. Thank you very much for your help, ma'am. I'll ask you more questions when you're ready.
Okay.
This is my real card. I'm a detective hired by John to protect him.
Tell me, what detective agency do you work for?
I'm a private investigator. I went to my room after I left.
I see. Do you remember Mr. Desire's first name?
I think it was E-I-R-I-K-R.
That could be anyone.
You're right, it really could be anyone.
Maybe the name means something else.
Sure.
A scandal at the local casino. When was this? Ah, 1928.
His morning jog. You won't need another surgery, will you, Eric? Well, we got home, as you know. Eric wanted to go to the local casino to have a little fun. About three.
Could I please get everyone to sign their names with both hands? And Elizabeth, a quick word, please. I need to ask you a very important question. Who was in the lounge last night? As you know, I got everyone to sign both of their names. The ones assigned with their left hand were Nathan, Eric, Elizabeth, and Owen. So, Mrs. North, Stephen Scott, and Allison were both innocent for the stabbing. Mr. North, Owen North, in order to have stolen that poison, you would have had to been here earlier in the day or left the poker table. Can anyone confirm this?
I can confirm I was with him all day.
I can confirm he was there all night.
Thank you. Now, Elizabeth, where were you last night when you left the lounge?
I can assure you, I never stole the poison.
Where were you, Elizabeth? Go on, tell Allison where you were.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Eric left his poker game at 17 past 8, which is the exact same time you left the lounge. I concluded he must have gone upstairs during dinner. I saw Eric wearing glasses. Those same glasses were left in your room next to a letter. I shall read the letter shortly.
What does Miss Baker seeing something outside of a window got anything to do with this?
The letter reads as follows. Dear Elizabeth, I'm going to do away with my wife so I can be with you, so to speak. But don't worry, not in that kind of way. But you must understand how she'll get in the way if something happens between us.
Ah, when she was reading the letter, she got a shock and made it up.
It's all very simple. He wanted to put innocent guilt on his wife to make her go to jail. How? Well, there's really no other evidence that concludes that it was really Eric. It connects to the Jones's family.
What? I'm not pretty enough. Tell me I'm pretty!
So who is the murderer?
I will get to that. During my investigation, I found footprints right outside of the crime scene. I identified those to be none other than yours, Eric.
I didn't murder him.
Well, Owen has been getting threat letters from him. How do we know it's from him? For him. The name Desire means Jones. Owen told me his first name was E-I-K-I-R, which is the Norse for Eric. This is how I see the events playing out. After Eric's business meeting with Mr. North, he finds Mr. Flint key and gets the rat poison. He poisons Mr. North's favourite food, but doesn't have any time to put the poison back. When he and his wife come over today, he does put it back. Me and Mr. Scott interrupt him when we go into the room. He is forced to jump out a window. That explains his limping when we go to the... Owen also told me of a scandal in a local casino that happened 20 years previously.
Dude, stop!
Thanks to his wife Megan, she informed us of his forgetfulness after he made the mistake of thinking he made a mistake. People with Alzheimer's disease only forget new memories.
You're quite a clever man, Mr. Wright. I didn't think you could do it. I'm not sorry for what I've done.
Let's get rid of this evil man.
Actually, you must have forgotten about that incident in the closet.
This is my real card. I'm a detective hired by John to protect him.
Last week, Owen was sent threat letters about his father.
How do you know Nathan didn't tell John?
Nathan was in on it with you. When you went in the hallway, you asked Nathan to get the container. He looked, but it wasn't there. Because the poison was gone, you had to come up with another plan. Nathan used the kitchen key and stabbed John with one of his knives. You see, John has had another child with another woman. This man, right here, is the child.
I was an orphan once. My father had dark brown hair, olive skin, and brown eyes.
Beans?
Oh, sorry, I'm very jumpy today.
Well, I did it for a good reason.
You reminded him so much of the girl he'd left behind. He regrets it, I tell you. He wanted to give you happiness. Who left her at a very young age, just after his wife died. I don't know what he thought, but maybe it was raising a child without a mother. No one will ever know why he left. Nathan has been working for John since he left his daughter.
Oh, ever since he had a son. Wait, no, sorry. Ever since he was rich, which was probably 20 years ago. Why do you think I did it? They won't stop, you know. Mr. Wright, they're coming to get you. And when they do, all Furno will break loose.
I hate you! Everything you've done to me, you low-down, rotten piece of garbage! You high above it all. Throw it all away, your love. Our love, don't throw it all away, your love. Don't throw it all away, your love. Our love, don't throw it all away, your love. Darkness.